Russian President Vladimir Putin believes Turkey is deliberately trying to bring relations between Moscow and Ankara to a standstill.
I cannot say that we consider absolutely inexplicable those treacherous backsteps from those whom we used to see as partners and allies in the fight against terrorism.
In what was expected after his assurance to France, British Prime Minister made a strong case for his country to start bombing ISIS militants in Syria without putting boots on the ground.
We shouldn't be content with outsourcing our security to our allies. If we believe that action can help protect us, then with our allies, we should be part of that action, not standing aside from it.
Friend and ally France, in the meantime, continues to rally other allies in an effort to wipe out ISIS. President Francois Hollande in the company of German Chancellor Angela Merkel on Wednesday. And in a show of solidarity with France, Italian Prime Minister Matteo Renzi also called on the French President in Paris. While France vows to destroy Islamic State, Hollande is due to hold talks in Moscow with Russian President Vladimir Putin on Thursday evening. Meanwhile, protests were seen outside the Turkish embassy in Moscow, calling the country murderers. Russia sent an advanced missile system to Syria on Wednesday to protect its jets operating there. They also defiantly continued flying missions near Turkish airspace 2 days after Turkey shot down a Russian fighter jet. Turkey earlier issued an audio recording of the warning it said it had sent 10 times to the Russian Su-24. The survivor navigator of the crash insisted they heard no such warning.
In actual fact, there were no warnings at all, neither by radio nor visually. There were no contacts whatsoever. That is why we were taking a military route in a normal mode.
While Moscow appears defiant, it is clear it does not want to jeopardize its main objective, to rally international support for its view on how the Syria conflict should be resolved. While the war rages in Syria and Russia's attacks have restricted movement of refugees in Turkey, U.S. President Barack Obama urged Americans to be receptive to Syrian refugees in his Thanksgiving message on Thursday, reminding them that the pilgrims who come to America in 1620 were themselves fleeing persecution.
In 1620, a small band of pilgrims came to this continent, refugees who had fled persecution and violence in their native land. Nearly 400 years later, we remember their part in the American story, and we honor the men and women who helped them in their time of need.
Meanwhile, Brussels remain on high alert even as schools and parts of the metro have reopened, as authorities continue to hunt for suspects linked to the Paris attacks that had triggered 4 days of lockdown in the Belgian, EU and NATO capital. Newsnight Desk, DD News.